This video represents general wiring instructions for Leviton Smart Lock Pro Arc Fault Circuit Interrupter Receptacles, Dual Function AFCI-GFCI Receptacles, Slim Series Ground Fault Circuit Interrupter Receptacles, and Renew GFCI Receptacles. For specific installation instructions on your Leviton receptacle, please consult the instruction sheet found with your product's packaging. In this video, we will show wiring with four wires plus ground to provide local as well as downstream protection to one or more outlets. Please be certain to follow all wiring instructions and diagrams provided with the product. If you're unsure about any part of the instructions, or if you're not comfortable or familiar with working with electrical wiring, contact an electrician. When installing and terminating these Leviton devices, have the following tools on hand: a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, electrician's pliers, a wire stripper, electrical tape, and a handheld voltage tester. This installation takes approximately 15 minutes. The process shown follows general guidelines. Local codes take precedence. Be sure to turn the power off at the circuit breaker and use a voltage tester to ensure that the power is completely off. AFCI, GFCI, and dual function outlets feature what is called feed-through protection. This means the protection in the device can be extended to other outlets on the circuit that are downstream from the device being installed. This is done by attaching the wires that lead to the downstream outlets onto the terminals that are marked load. Important: when installing the outlet, it should be installed as the first outlet closest to the load center on that circuit in order to maximize protection. If you're not certain which outlet is the first, contact an electrician. These devices offer the option of either wrapping leads around the terminal screws or using an external backwire clamp. We're going to demonstrate backwiring. Begin by identifying wall box wires. It is important not to install one of these devices in an electrical box exceeding four wires plus the ground. If you see more than four wires plus the ground in the wall box you're working on, contact an electrician. Now, we need to identify the hot wire. To do this, turn the circuit breaker back on. Carefully use the voltage tester to test each wire. The hot wire will be indicated by the tester. Once identified, turn off the circuit breaker to shut power and test to ensure that the power is off. Use a small piece of electrical tape to label the hot wire. Note that in this example, there is a black hot line wire, a black load wire, two white neutral wires, and a bare copper wire, which is the ground. Next, you need to be sure that the wires are prepared for installation. Start by making sure the wires are straight and stripped according to the strip gauge located on the back of the device. We will now wire the device. There are guide channels to help keep the wire in place. Begin with the line wires to the line terminals. The line terminals are those without the yellow sticker. The white line wire connects to the silver terminal, and the black line wire connects to the hot brass terminal. Use a screwdriver and rotate the terminal screw clockwise to tighten the conductor portion under the clamp. Give a tug afterwards to assure the wire is securely terminated. Then, connect the load wires to the load terminals. Remove the yellow sticker to reveal the load terminals. The white load wire connects to the silver terminal, and the black load wire connects to the hot brass terminal. Use a screwdriver and rotate the terminal screw clockwise to tighten the conductor portion under the clamp. Give a tug afterwards to assure the wire is securely terminated. The last step is to terminate the ground wire, which is the green or bare copper wire. Ground screws are always hexagonal in shape and colored green. We will follow the same procedure as with the other terminals. Use a screwdriver and rotate the terminal screw clockwise to tighten the conductor portion under the clamp. Give a tug afterwards to assure the wire is securely terminated. Your SmartLock Pro device is now terminated. Secure the device in the wall box and cover with a wall plate. Restore power at the circuit breaker. The device is now ready for use. We recommend you conduct a quick test of the reset functionality. GFCIs and AFCIs are shipped from the factory in the tripped condition and cannot be reset until wired correctly and power is supplied to the device. Plug a lamp or radio into the device and leave it plugged in. Ensure that the device is still in the tripped condition by pressing the test button. If the indicator light on the device face is on and the lamp or radio is off, go to the troubleshooting section of the instructions because line and load wiring connections have been reversed. You will not be able to reset the device in this condition. Press the reset button fully. If the lamp or radio turns on and the indicator light turns on, the device has been installed correctly. If the device cannot be reset, go to the troubleshooting section. All Leviton AFCI and GFCI devices now have an automated self-testing feature based on latest product standards, but it's still a good idea to test the devices manually every month. For more information on AFCI, GFCI, and dual-function AFCI-GFCI receptacles from Leviton, visit leviton.com/protection.